Yeah, I've not videoed.
Have you never used
before,
the video on the phone? Right? Oh my god.
First time videoing.
Seriously.
There we are. We're in the car.
Yeah, we're on the way to Ben's Stag.
Yeah.
Going slightly slowly on the M5 at the moment, so we're almost there, like 12 minutes away. And our first activity is quad biking, which also has some buggies in it as well, so that should be hilarious. So I look forward to doing some drifting round corners, if possible.
Yeah. Jin's concerning my foot off in the shorts.
Yeah, I have got some very tasty shorts on my legs out, so if you can see, have you got evidence, yeah? And the vile green shorts. But that should be quite good. And then we're going back to the hotel, the same hotel that we had for Grant's Stag. And then we've got a pub quiz crawl thing, which will be terrible. And it's on an app, so yeah. I've never done those sorts of things before. I did one around the zoo in London, London Zoo, and that was actually quite good. So if it's anything like that, it should be like riddles and singing songs and stuff, and trying to get and talk to random people and scare them.
We have a nice surprise for Ben later as well, which we might do at that stage. So video evidence to follow.
Oh yes, yeah. So we'll be taking many videos we'll go through today. And some photos, and then we've got I don't know, are we going somewhere to get something to eat, because the comedy clubs are like
I think it's going to be quick. We're like an hour.
Yeah, it's just not long at all.
Well actually 2 hours if you go for when the doors close, so we'll probably do that.
Yeah,
but yeah, should be good. We know the area already because of Grant Stag, so we should be a lot more organised and know what we're doing.
Yeah, have we got any good places to go and drink and eat?
I think some guys have done some googling.
Good
four-star reviews, apparently.
Woo, four stars. Ooh. We're going fancy today. Although our hotel is 2 stars.
Yeah.
So it's supposed to be 3, but it was downgraded because of the local noise and obviously all the stags, which obviously don't sort of degrade these sorts of things.
Yeah. So it's become a stag hotel and a Hindu hotel. I'm not even kidding. You go in and there's like multiple parties.
It was very dodgy. And it should be fun.
Yeah.
And then we'll see where we get to later, after the comedy club, there's a few strip club options, which, we can take Ben to. Don't tell Louise that.
It's a joke.
Yeah, it's a joke, yeah. We're being banterous.
That's a new word, banterous.
Banterous, isn't it? Yeah, so, and then it'll be probably, God knows where. So, yeah, so that'll be the Stag. So, yeah, we'll take various videos as we go through.
Cool.
So watch out for those.
To the Stag.
See you later.
Right, just about to go on the test run for the quad bikes.
The excitement.
You can feel the excitement in the air. Ben, photo. Oh, he's off. Go, follow on.
Go, Jamie, go.
Woo! He stalled it? Braked.
Oh, my God, you're fat.
You're going to get so muddy.
This is why I haven't even showered. I'm showering now.
I can see the mud. Well, that was exciting, wasn't it? That was the first one. Already had one person off. Sam has managed to get it off the course. First 5 minutes. Woo! Here he goes. Run, run, run. It turns out that Ollie has literally just hit one of the tyres and then the little Ollie has just gone into his car and just chucked him back in again. It's amazing. First lap. Hey! Go on, Ben.
Who's going to be the first to spin out? That
it looks slow from here, but I suspect it's pretty fast when you're in these things.
You don't have Brecken, Brad. I think Brad might throw it out.
He wasn't aggressive on the bike. So.
He wasn't actually. Well, he was on the second time when he was like on Ben's ass.
But oh, look at that.
Sunday.
Woo!
What's that? How size the engine? 600cc. What's that? How much they cost?
So Ben, we've got you a little something. A few of us had a revenge, apparently. Not me, but some others. So you have your very own ginger spice dress.
Oh my god.
And it does fit. I made sure of it.
Have you tried this on?
Only briefly.
Day by day.
Do you like the way the sequence
values? I do. I really like Union Jack stuff.
Is it?
I don't like Union Jack stuff.
Actually, a dress.
Oh my god.
It's a real dress. Like, yeah. Give it to Lou, she can wear it after.
Hey, it's probably the right size as well.
Let's try it.
Oh wow, that's very low cut.
Yeah, there's a reason I asked you to wear shorts. You've got your schlong with hanging
just,
out.
Just wear boxes.
Just wear boxes. Don't even wear boxes. Get like a
box. Put it on, we'll see what it's. Yeah, let's see where we're at.
You didn't make me wear
it. Go on, get it on.
Shirt coming up.
Yeah, yeah, go on in.
Woo!
Oh, yeah.
Go on, one for the ladies.
We figured you wouldn't need a wig because you're already ginger spice.
It fits very well. That's very well fitting. Right, move out of the way of the chair. Give us a spin. Oh, look at that. Ooh, hey.
Oh, please, can you go out?
Please, can you go and go out in your boxes and let's do a test in your boxes, yeah? You can take your shorts off now. Go on, look, give it a go.
Sit down.
Just wear boxes.
It's up to you. No, it's not.
He wasn't mean to me, whereas that's...
Did you bring your heels?
I didn't bring my heels. I might change some different shoes. Like, this is a little bit
weird. That's what looks weird.
Yeah, that's an interesting look. We're now walking through the middle of Bristol, and here we have our lovely Jerry Hallowell looking fine in a dress. Yeah, and we're just about to walk through some sort of like civil, sort of everyone's very dressed up and fancy and stuff, so it's gonna be very good. Oh, we're going across the grass. What? Did you feel bad? Nah, it's embarrassing, it's supposed to be. Woo, Ben Stag. Oh, canapes, wonderful. Looking good. Pulling the skirt down. Oh, yes. So we've come to Pyminster for our pies. Hey! And now we managed to get cocktails. Long Island iced tea is going to screw us up massively. And yeah, so what pies are we on? I'm on Chicken of Aragon. You're on Fungi.
Fungi.
Blue pie.
Free moo.
Woo!
The cow. I'm getting cow.
Yeah, and how are we doing with the points?
We are winning.
We're winning.
So how many points ahead?
Still eating.
And we can eat, and then we can still win.
Yeah, exactly. So, before the coffee cup, we're going to head about 7 o'clock. and then try and get a couple more points, and then we'll probably be done. Yeah, but there's no prize for the win, it's just the street credit saying give me one.
Yeah. And then we'll rub in our faces.
Yeah, we will do. Well, literally.
And he will be very sorry if he loses.
Awesome, yeah. So yeah, we'll see you later. Start. Everyone say hello. Woo! Comedy Club. Woo! Ben looking gorgeous in his dress. And if you're looking for the results of the competition, unfortunately our group didn't win, but we got pie instead, so we're happy with that.
Yeah,
so you can see your smug face, but you're so hungry right now.
I'm not hungry.
Well, it's just yet.
I'll probably be hungry about this time this dish is done, and I'll go off and get some food and I'll be happy.
Well, he'll enjoy that then. Speak to you later.
He will help solve the crime. I've also got here this man. What's your name? Kim, hold that. That's yours. Hold it. Can you say for us, Kim? So, I've got here a story from my uncle. He was a detective. We're going to read this out. I've got the script here, and Ben is going to do some actions. He will make some sound effects. He'll make the story come to life as we solve the crime. Are you ready, Ben? Let's solve this murder. Here we go, guys.
Come on, Jerry. Oh,
quick. So, the year was 1945, and so was the time. All was quiet at the station. In the hallway, a broken grandfather clock struck one. Not bad, stop. Outside, the silence broke with a twinkle of an owl. A rumble of thunder. And the sound of wind. But it's so new. The inspector sat in his room, and he rocked back and forth in his chair, which creaked loudly. It's so good. He cleared his throat noisily. Brilliant. And began working on a new case. Suddenly, the inspector's mobile rang, sounding its distinctive ringtone. That highly distinctive ringtone. Terrible news. Up at Cooler House, there'd been the most horrible murder. You guys are good. Inspector Riley gave a heavy sigh. How we hated Cooler House. People always getting murdered. Always the same six suspects, six weapons, and nine rooms. Not one was ever a toilet. Crazy. The inspector shuddered, packed his case, ran to his car, slammed the door, switched off, and switched on his summary. At the mansion, Riley switched to a halt. He walked to the house and rang the doorbell. It wasn't working, so instead he rapped on the door. Oh, brilliant. And from within, the voice of an elderly lady said, brilliant. And rather nervously, she added,
who is that?
Riley pushed open the door with a long, agonised creak. Immediately, the inspector saw a melancholy woman, body like a melon, face like a collie. It was Mrs. Peacock. At her feet lay a corpse, the corpse of Mr. Bonney.
Ooh.
No! Dun dun dun! The corpse of Mr. Bonney!
Dun dun dun!
As usual, the house, no one cared by him being killed, but Riley smiled dryly. As he looked at a list of all the combinations, I've worked it out. There's 324 combinations of rooms, suspects, and weapons. The inspector laughed. Girlishly. and began to finger the old shirt in the room.
Shut up!
You feel proud. The inspector instructed me to move a large pair of scissors up and down the list of suspects. suspects and will shout stop in a second. Suddenly, Riley began to receive one of his psychic visions, his face contorted. As he whimpered, his body writhed. he let out a deep-throated cry. That's more like it. Okay, so we've got here, this is it, we've got here our list of all the suspects. Inspector Riley, you're going to shout stop, it's up to you, down to you, the whole trip down to you. So, you shout stop.
Stop.
Okay, so cover, that's yours, grab that, that's yours, grab it, bring up. Okay, fantastic, he's got the list there. So, as he cuts the paper in his hand, Riley leaped to his feet and shouted, I know who did it.
I know who did it.
In his deep Scottish brogue. Scottish. Next few days in his office, he heard the sound of footsteps on the gravel. It is you. It was the cheery postwoman. She stepped forward. Handed me a package and took off all her clothes. She turned left in a jubilant wave. Oh, lovely. Now, can you check? Who have you cut to? Who got there? Who's done it? What's the cut to?
Colonel Mustard.
Dagger, kitchen. You can serve our crowd here. They're all different. All combinations mixed up, all different.
Yep.
You have different rooms, people. You've got Colonel Mustard, Dagger, kitchen. Okay, famous. So Shirley Riley opened up the envelope. There's a copy of that day's Daily Bugle. Has he sold the card? You chose that. You held that. Let's find out. Mustard, Dagger, kitchen. In nice loud voice, Ben, what the headlines say?
Mustard, Dagger, kitchen.
He sold the card! Come on!
Crank, she said, baby, love you, baby, at the mall. I'm saying, the conclusion of Ben's Stag. Mm-hmm. We are currently sat in Tesco's in Bristol on the way out, having a full English breakfast to try and ease the stomachs and a little bit of caffeine to brighten the mood.
Yeah.
It's been very quiet this morning.
We only got in like 6 a.m. So.
Yeah, it was a very long and very good night. So, as you saw earlier, you know, we obviously did all the quad biking and the carts and the then coming into town, doing the pub quiz thing, which was brilliant with Jerry Halliwell, star of the show. And it got to, I love the Pie Minster thing. So we went, our group, we went and got the pies, but the other group beat us in points because they kept going. But my God, were they much more hammered than us later on. Yeah. So bad, yeah.
I rubbed it in.
Oh, yeah, we just kept reminding them.
Yeah, when they were hungry, they were great in that.
Yeah, God.
I've been taken back to the pie shop when it was closed, just rub it in.
Yeah, that was excellent. That was very well done. Just as they were packing up, that was really good. Yeah. So they had to go out and get like chips and falafel burgers and falafel and stuff. Yeah. Oh, it was like horrible. Yeah, and then me and Jake went into Sainsbury's and got, I got bulgur wheat and feta sandwich and some chicken just to keep me going, which is very posh. It made me feel better rather than having another pie or, you know, so that. So we then went into comedy club, but then, Sam and Ben, they were really going on it as well. So they were, you know, going for the quite a few beers in the comedy club. But it was excellent. The comedy club itself was superb. And you've seen the video of Ben being on stage with the magician guy. But then it was mainly the MC that was just picking on Jake. It was awesome, just being the fit guy in the crowd. Obviously, and Grant being the geek in the Captain America t-shirt at the start. So that was actually really good. Actually, it was much better than last time in the comedy club. That was much better. There's a bigger crowd and there was a good mix of people, and the performances were better. That was right. Then we came out and then we went into BSB, which is a dance club. We went to try and get some food. And then we did some street dancing. Yeah, that was it.
With a saxophone player. Saxophone.
That was quite fun.
I think we played like 6 or 7 songs.
Yeah, a lot of Oasis.
Yeah.
That was good.
Then we went to a club, almost like a folk gypsy band first.
Yeah.
Then we went to the dance
club. Oh, yeah, that's it, yeah. Yeah. Mm. But the folk gypsy band was very odd, really random music.
Yeah, well, the guy was a bit shit. So.
Yeah. it was enthusiastic and, sort of middle aged men with the guitars and stuff. So it was alright. And the drinks were pretty good, actually, good selection. And then went to this club, BSB. It was more like a bar that you can dance on, very wet floors, and it was very studenty, so it was messy but good fun. I mean, spilling drinks everywhere, but fine.
Yes, we met this guy who was like so smooth in his dancing, like Michael Jackson.
He looked like he was like 16.
He looked young.
Really young, but it was impressive. I think we need to learn these skills training. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's going to have some lessons. And then there was after that was then Prism, wasn't it? Which was the big nightclub where we had the comedy club. And we got in 5 o'clock, yeah.
Yeah, like
yeah, and then probably sleep about 6 after crashing out. And then getting up at 10, like, nice solid 4 hours of sleep. Shower, get downstairs, go. So we're now on our way home. Not to sleep, I've got stuff to be doing today. I've got to go and move some stuff around my house and my grandparents' house. He's sleeping, so it's all right. It was a good time. So hopefully we'll see you in whatever event we do in the future. Another vlog. See you later.